Hello and welcome to Daily Current Affairs by UPSC CSE. Today is 9th June 2019 and the topic we are going to discuss is SPICE 2000 International Corpus Sarsat Program, Golden Lanku, Lothal, Map-Aided Program and the previous year question revision series. So coming to the first topic, that's the SPICE 2000. So this is in news because the Indian Air Force, they have signed a 300 crore deal with Israeli government to buy as many as 100 spice bombs which will be used in airstrike, which was used in airstrikes in Pakistan's Balakot area. So these are spice stands for smart, precise, import, cost effective bomb. Okay, it's a guidance kit powered by electro optics and GPS for converting the unguided airdroppable bombs into precision guided bombs. So, it was developed by Israel and India has been using SPICE 2000 bombs since 2015 on this Mirage 2000. That's a French developed fighter jet, Mirage 2000. So, I have a picture of SPICE 2000. Okay. The main features are it has a standoff range of 60 kilometers. Then it come equipped with a family of weapons used for air-to-ground operations. Then it is combined with the advantage of satellite guidance and those of the electro-optical guidance into one bomb. Okay, and the satellite guidance, it will allow to engage the camouflaged and hidden target to provide a drop and forget option. Okay, and it operates in all weathers and lightning conditions also. The electro optical guidance, it will allow the man in the loop guidance to the engage the relocatable targets. Okay, and it will be having independence from the external information sources like satellites. Okay, and the SPICE bomb kit, it consists of an inertial navigation satellite guidance and electro-optical sensors also for pinpoint accuracy. Okay, this is very sophisticated bomb and it is difficult to detect on radars. And due to their small size, they can be used from a standoff range to destroy the target also. And also, a heavy cloud cover or even the bad weather has little effect on their outcome. Okay, next is International Corpus Sarsat Program. So, ISRO, it's been a party to International Corpus Sarsat Program. They still couldn't find the missing, aircraft AN-32. So, the International Corpus Sarsat Program, it's a satellite-based search and rescue distress alert detection and information distribution system. It's SAR. Okay, it is an organization. It is a treaty-based organization. It's non-profit, intergovernmental, humanitarian organization. It has 45 nations and various agencies coming together. And it is best known for detecting and locating emergency beacon activated by the aircraft, ship and the background country hikers in distress. So, the program, it began as a joint effort between Canada, France, US and the former Soviet Union. It started in 1979. So it was formally constituted as an intergovernmental organization and then it was signed basically by four parties like Canada, France, US and former USSR. So the Russian Federation, they replaced USSR and become a party in 1992. Okay, the main objective is to provide accurate, timely and reliable distress alert and location data and to assist person in distress. And another objective is to reduce the delay in the provision of distress alert to the SAR services. Then again, in order to maintain, coordinate and operate a satellite system which is capable of detecting distress alert transmission is also the function of this organization. Okay. So, the next topic is Golden Langur. Golden Langur, it is in news because it is to get the fruits of MGNREGA also. So, for the first time since the MGNREGA program was launched in 2005, it will have a non-human beneficiary, that is the Golden Langur, in the reserve forest of Assam, in the western Assam. Okay, Bongaigaon district. Okay, 27.24 lakh project to plant trees in Assam's Kokaijana forest. That will, you know, encourage or sustain the colonies of endangered primates. So that's a work coming under MGNREG. Okay, this is Golden Langur. That's a photo. So Golden Langur is old world monkey. It is found in western Assam in India and also in Black Mountains of Bhutan. So it is also called as Geese Golden Langur or Golden Leaf Monkey. It is one of the 15 species that's primates from India. The 15 primate species of India, 9 are found in Assam. And the Golden Langur is one of it found in Assam. So the scientific name is basically Trachypithecus ghee, and it is basically a primate family. So it is found, as I told you, it is found in western Assam, that is northeastern India, then you can find it in Bhutan. The primate species, it is confined to a forest belt in western Assam between the Manas River in the east and the Sankosh River in the west, and the Brahmaputra to the south, and Indo-Bhutan border to the top. So the distribution of Golden Langur in Bhutan is limited to the foothills of the Black Mountain. Okay. Main threats may be like habitat loss due to deforestation. That is why we are planting trees now. So deforestation, then electrocution from power lines, then hunting by dogs, various diseases among the the breeds. These are all the basic threats, major threats of Golden Langur. And regarding the conservation status, it is endangered in the IUCN Red List, Schedule 1 of the WPA Act, and Appendix 1 of the sites. Very important animal, right? So Chakrashila Wildlife Sanctuary and the Manas Wildlife Sanctuary in Assam are the two protected habitat for this species in India. Next topic is Lothal. So Lothal is in news because India and Portugal will cooperate in setting up of a national maritime heritage museum. National maritime heritage museum in at Lothal. Lothal is in Gujarat. So the Indian Navy, they'll be a stakeholder in the project, and the Portuguese Navy, they have agreed to assist with their experience of administering a maritime museum. They have a similar museum in Lisbon also. So, they'll associate with the Indian Navy in order to build this Maritime Heritage Museum at Lothal. So, the project is being implemented by Ministry of Shipping for sure. This is being done as a part of Sagarmala program. There will be active association of the Archaeological Survey of India. Then the state government and other stakeholders will also be there. Okay. So, Lothal, it is... very famous because you must have heard Lothal a lot of times in Indus Valley Civilization. So Lothal was one of the, southernmost cities of the Indus Valley Civilization, ancient Indus Valley Civilization. Now it is, in Bhal region of the modern state of Gujarat. And it was discovered in 1954. It was excavated at that point of time. And Lothal has the world's earliest known dockyard. Which connected the city to an ancient course of Sabarmati River. Okay. Next is map aided program. I have national parks of Jharkhand. We have only one national park in Jharkhand. That's a Betla National Park. We have pretty famous wildlife sanctuaries in Jharkhand, like Palamau Tiger Reserve and all. But we will, discuss wildlife sanctuary on a different note, on a different day. We'll concentrate on wildlife sanctuaries as well. Now we are dealing only with the national parks. So yesterday we covered Uttar Pradesh and Bihar, which again has only one national park. So Jharkhand is again having only one national park. So we'll finish off the small things so that we can concentrate more on like Madhya Pradesh. And Madhya Pradesh have around 9 national parks. So it's very hard to study, So we'll finish off the small things first. Then we'll go to bigger things. So, Betla National Park is a beautiful place located in the Chota Nagpur Plateau. It is in the Latehar district of Jharkhand. So, Betla, the name came from the acronym of the words bison, elephant, tiger, leopard and axis. Axis is a kind of fox, I think. Okay. So, please check it. So, as the name suggests, it is famous for bison, elephant, tiger, leopard and axis. Okay, it's very easy to remember. Okay, Betla National Park is towards the southernmost part of Jharkhand. Fine. Okay. Next is the PQRS. So, I'll read out the question. What is the advantage or advantages of implementing National Agricultural Market Scheme? So, it is a pan-India electronic trading portal for agricultural commodities. Yes, true it is. It provides a farmer access to nationwide market with prices commensurate with the quality of their produce. That is very positive statement. Yes, that is also a function of National Agricultural Market. So, the answer is C. Whenever you encounter with a very positive statement, please try to connect it with a question. So, first read out the question, then read the option, then again go to the question and try to connect it with the question. So, once you read the question, you will be like, this is National Agricultural Market Scheme. This is about, you will have a prejudiced feeling about the thing you read in the question. Then, if you come to the option, then you will be having a different feeling about it. So, you will find the option is also correct. Okay, this is also correct. Then, you again go for the question. Whether the question is addressed in the option is what we have to check. Okay, not whether the question is correct or the option is correct. No. If the option is the appropriate answer to the question or not. That is what we have to check here. So, here the both statement is very positive and you know the right answer. So, the option is C, 1 and 2. So, that's all for today guys. I hope you enjoyed the session. So, we'll see tomorrow. Have a nice day. Good night.